Crafters, I'm Daniela with DD's Art Workshop. If you like staying on a budget and DIYs, this channel is for you. For today's DIY, we will be making a piñata, and you will have no need to use paper mache for this DIY. In Mexico, posada parties are very popular, and you will always find a piñata hanging from the ceilings. These are popular additions to nearly every Mexican party, and of course, Christmas is no exception. This DIY is part of the Christmas Holly Around the World Challenge with, once again, irreplaceable, irresistible, unmistakable, remarkable, best of the best creators. Please make sure to check out each host in the link below and the full playlist for you to have a chance to win a gift of 19 gifts under the Christmas tree for this challenge. Please read the description below for more details. Look out for my secret word and comment it in the comment section below for a chance to win. Now let's jump right in and let's get crafty. So to start off, I had this large Amazon cardboard box, and it's pretty thick, so I really love it because it's gonna work perfect for this piñata. I have already drawn a Frida figure, and it's so simple. It does not have to be perfect. And once I cut that out, I'm gonna go ahead and trace it on another cardboard piece, so I have two exact pieces. With the ruler, I'm gonna kind of get an idea on how thick I want my piñata, and I want it to be 5 inches thick. So using the same cardboard, I'm gonna go ahead and do two strips that are 5 inches thick or wide. And I do want my carton to be a little bit more flexible, and that way I can mold it into the shape that I want. So I am rolling it up, and I'm gonna just flip my cardboard over, and I'm gonna do the same to the other side, and you'll see what I'm talking about in just a minute. This is basically helping, that way the carton is not so stiff and hard. Now I'm ready to glue. And I'm gonna go ahead and just glue this carton all along the edges of my Frida head. And as you can see here, I am using my small glue gun because the large one that I had ordered didn't come in on time. I will be using it at the end of this video, you will see. But I do suggest you use a bigger glue gun because the glue is gonna come out more than the smaller one. And it just took me forever with the smaller glue gun, and you really want a lot of glue on here because you want it to be very secure, and you want that piñata to really stay and be really, really durable. And I personally like to use my Gorilla Glue Gun and Gorilla Glue Sticks because I just find it to be a little bit more tougher, and I do use this glue on certain projects when I really want that extra security. And what you're seeing now that I've been doing is I'm adding extra glue on the sides because I just want as much glue as I can on here. And as you can see, my little glue gun is taking me forever because only a little bit of glue comes out. So like I said, make sure you use your larger glue gun. Okay, so now I'm using my second strip of carton, and I'm just gonna add some glue on the side, and I really want to double layer it just so I have a thicker border. And I'm just gonna glue all the way until I get to the end, as you can see right now. And I'm gonna just go ahead and do the same thing I did earlier and just glue all my carton to the edges of Frida's head. And when I say I really do want to add extra glue, I'm even doing it on the edges, every single little place where I think I need glue. So don't be afraid to use a lot of glue on this DIY. Go crazy. Okay. Okay, y'all, now that we have that bottom part set, we are ready to add our top part of Frida's head. So I'm just adding glue and I am just gluing little by little so my glue doesn't dry. I'm lifting it up a little bit, adding glue and just gluing it down and so forth until I get the whole head glued down all the way around. And of course, what I'm doing now is once again adding more glue all on the edges so I have enough glue because I really want it to be nice and tight and I do not want my piñata to fall apart. And guys, I am feeling this piñata nice and strong. Okay, y'all, and you're probably wondering where the heck are those candies gonna go? I am doing a little square on the side of the head, and with a razor blade, I'm simply cutting three sides. Do not cut the whole square off. And it's gonna be like a little door, just like so. And this little opening is at the top left-hand side. You will see it better in just a bit. Now I'm gonna be doing two holes at the top of Frida's head, and these are gonna be in the center. This is where my ribbon is gonna go, where we are gonna hang that piñata. Now I had this ribbon in my craft stash. It is from Dollar Tree and it is in teal because I want my piñata to be colorful. I am gonna insert it in one of the holes with my scissors, and through that opening that I made, I'm gonna stick my hand and I am gonna go ahead and take that ribbon out from the other hole and tie a knot, then a bow, and make it real, real tight so that piñata doesn't come off. Okay, y'all, so my lifesaver has arrived, the larger Gorilla glue gun, which I am so excited to use because this glue gun is gonna give me more glue, which is the one I should have been using in the first place. Anyway, now we are ready to cover our piñata in streamers. And this streamer I had, it's in the color cream. I had it in my stash, and I'm just gonna fold it in this length, give or take. And I'm just gonna fold a lot of it. That way I have a lot of fringes. You will see in just a second how I'm gonna make those. Okay, so now with my scissors, I'm gonna cut my streamer just like so. Don't cut it all the way. We just want little fringes, and we're gonna cover our piñata with this streamer. And you'll see how we're gonna do that in just a second. When you open up your streamer, it should look just like this. And we're gonna just make a whole bunch of these. And you're gonna just use one roll for this DIY. And I'm actually using just regular Elmer's glue for this DIY. And make sure you do get enough glue because I did end up using two of these whole containers for this whole piñata. And basically all you're doing here is applying glue, and with the paintbrush, just smooth that glue out and then just add your fringes and cut to your desired length to the shape of the piñata. And this is basically all you're gonna be doing for this. And it is not hard, but it is very time consuming. So go ahead and just relax, listen to some music, put on your podcast or call a friend, cause it's gonna take a while, but it's very relaxing. And do remember to always start from the bottom up so your fringes are nice and neat. It's gonna be kind of awkward if you do start from the top. So remember, always start from the bottom. Now, on the top of Frida's head, as you can see, it has a little curve. And what I love about this streamer is you can just mold it to the shape you want. And I have that little curve at the top of Frida's head. Now we are ready to move on to the black. And I did purchase this black streamer at Dollar Tree, and it's a very big size. And I actually only used one roll. And we're doing the same method we did on the cream, and we're just doing some fringes, and we are ready to add the hair just like so. I'm actually only gonna be using this piñata for display in my dining room because it's a Mexican theme, but if you're planning to hit this piñata, you can always add multiple layers of the streamers just to have a thicker surface, and when you hit it, it just doesn't come apart that easily. For this side, I'm gonna stop right here and I'm gonna do the same thing to the left side. And now I'm ready to do the top of Frida's head, and we are just gonna glue the black streamer just like so. And I'm just gonna give Frida's hair a little bit of a shape just like this. Okay, and we're not done yet. We have done the top portion of Frida's head. Now we are ready to do the side. And you're gonna wanna start from the bottom like I mentioned before, and we are gonna start with the cream color to match her face. And we're gonna stop at the black, and we're gonna switch to the black streamers and then go from there. And it should look like this. Your cream will match your cream, your black, and we're gonna continue all the way to the top with black, and you're gonna watch me do the top just like so. And the secret word of my video is posada party. And you can go ahead and use it any way you'd like. Let me know if you've been to one, if you don't know what it means, or whatever you think it means. Remember to comment in the comments below to get a chance to win one of the 19 gifts for this DIY challenge and giveaway. And remember that opening for the candy? This is the way we're gonna wrap it up with streamers. That way you don't really see the opening. It's gonna be camouflaged by the black streamers. And remember, this is gonna be at the top left-hand side. And this is the way the little door or the little opening for the candy is gonna look like. Once it's dry, you can go ahead and just put it back and close it. Now let's continue and finish the top of Frida's head. We just need to cover that top, and we are ready to do the back. Now you can go ahead and turn Frida over, and from the bottom, remember, start from the bottom. I am using a bigger paintbrush because the area is much larger and it's just gonna go straight all the way from one end to another. So I just wanna go ahead and just finish faster. I'm adding more glue, as you can see, covering more area. That way I can add more strips one after another. And it shouldn't take you that long if you do it this way. Okay, and now we are ready to start on Frida's flowers, because you know she needs those flowers on her head. And for this DIY, we are gonna be using some tissue paper. You can get this at Dollar Tree, and I am folding it until I get this little square shaped. And of course, then I'm gonna just cut it. I'm actually only gonna be using 8 sheets per flower. And this is gonna be for Frida's flowers, of course, like I mentioned earlier. Once you have those square sheets and you have gotten 8 of them, we're gonna fold it just like this, and it's gonna look like a little accordion. Then with some ribbon or with some string, whatever you have, we're gonna tie it from the middle just like so, and we are gonna be ready to open this little flower up in just a second. Separate each sheet of your tissue paper individually to the same side gently and very, very softly, because you don't want your tissue paper to tear. And just puff it up as you go along, and we're gonna be doing this to both sides. Once you do one side, you are ready to poof out the other. And remember, we are doing it all towards the same side because we're gonna glue it from the back. And I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward this part because you already kinda saw how I did that first half of the flower. So I hope you got the hang of it, and it should look just like this. I've done some flowers already in other colors like yellow, blue, green, and pink. And now I'm ready to hot glue in the desired shape I want on top of Frida's head. Now for Frida's face, I'm gonna be using this cardstock paper, and I actually bought this at Dollar Tree. I'm gonna do Frida's eyebrows, you know, that unibrow, her signature unibrow, and I made this stencil for myself, and I'm just gonna cut that out, and I'm gonna go ahead and glue that in just a bit. I also made myself some eyes for Frida, and I'm gonna be making two eyeballs, I guess you could say. And I'm just gonna cut one out, and then with that same eye, I'm gonna trace the other one so they are the same exact shape. And with the same black I used earlier, I'm gonna make Frida's eyelashes. And once again, I made a stencil for myself. I'm gonna flip the eyelash over so it's kind of like the opposite of the other one. And that way they are the same exact shape. And that way my Frida doesn't look all weird and funky. And I don't want one eye to look different than the other one. Now for the inside of Frida's eyes, we are gonna be using this beige. You really can't see the color, the true color from the camera, but we are gonna be making two circles in this color. And to go inside of that white, we're gonna be making two smaller black circles in that same black we used earlier. And we're gonna be making four small little circles to go inside of the eye. And now we're gonna do Frida's earrings in this sparkly cardstock that was also in the little Dollar Tree packet. And I think this is just gonna add a nice little detail. And of course, we need Frida's small red lips. And these are also out of cardstock. And we're gonna do a small little curve for Frida's nose. That way she doesn't go without a nose. And now for the fun part, we get to put Frida's face together. And with my hot glue gun, I'm gonna go ahead and just glue each part down. And for the eye, I actually glued the eyes first. And I wanted to hold down my eye, that way it wouldn't be wobbling around. It's actually placed the way I want it, and I don't want her face to move. So I had this little planter, and I'm gonna go ahead and put it on top of her eyeball while I glue her eyelashes. And I'm gonna do the same for the other eye. And then for her nose, I'm actually gonna be using Elmer's glue since it's so little. And for the lips, just glue with your hot glue gun. I'm loving the way this pinata looks, and I'd love to show you a paper mache pinata for next time, so make sure to subscribe to be notified on my next DIY. And also for some yummy recipes that we also make for Christmas. You guys, in this challenge reminded me of John 16:33. I don't know what you're going through, but I'd like to remind you. The Bible says, "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world." If you liked this DIY, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on your notification bell. It really helps my channel. And don't forget to spread love, kindness, and stay crafty.